Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cream cheese candy. And I'm making this for Christmas, so I'm going to color it red and green, and then I'll probably have some white candy left as well. The way we make this is to start by using 3 ounces of cream cheese. And I put that in a medium or large size bowl. And to that, we're going to add peppermint flavoring. And this is a tiny amount because it's a tiny amount of cream cheese. This is just 1/4 teaspoon. If you want to change that flavor, you may use vanilla, or you may use almond, or whatever you think you would like with a cream cheese type candy. But I chose this for Christmas purposes. Now I'm going to be adding powdered sugar, or you might call it confectioner sugar or icing sugar. And here I have 1 cup. And 2 more cups, total of 3 cups. But I'm going to add it 1.5 cups the first time and then work in the rest of it. So this is 1 cup, and then I'm going to just dip down in here to get about 1/2 cup. And it doesn't have to be exact, just approximately 1.5 cups, and then use a mixer in order to get this smooth. Then I'll be adding the rest of that confectioner sugar. This is what your candy looks like after 1.5 cups of confectioner sugar has been beaten in. So I have 1.5 cups left here. I don't expect that I can put it all in and have it work really well, so I'm just going to add a little at a time. This is what our candy mixture looks like after we have mixed in all 3 cups of the confectioner sugar. At this point, I've kind of formed it into a ball. I did use my hands to get the last little bit worked in because it was getting very hard to do with a spoon and impossible to do with the mixer. But get it into a ball like this, or a rectangle, whatever you want. And then I have 3 bowls sitting out here, and the purpose of those is to have separate colors. So we're just going to leave 1/3 of this white. So here we have the white color, and it's ready to go in terms of making this into little pieces of candy. And then I said this was going to be green coming up next, so I'm going to use this gel food color, and I'm not giving any particular amount because you can make this any shade of green that you want, but I would advise you to take a metal spoon because your wooden spoon will get stained very badly, and then just work that in until you have a nice color of green. I'll come back to that and I'll add what I need, and then this one is going to be the one which is red. Again, gel food coloring. And if you're making this for a different occasion other than Christmas, then you won't want these bright green and red colors. For Easter, you might want some pastel colors. You might want to put a little bit of green, a little bit of blue, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of red, making a pink color. So this is a great candy for doing that. But let me work on this just a little bit, and I hope to come up with my mixture, which is white, and the one which is green, a dark Christmassy green, and a dark Christmassy red. Now I have my 3 colors of cream cheese candy, and the first one is white. There's not quite as much of it. And what I have here is a little scoop that you can use for a purpose like this. If you have drop cookies, or in this case it's candy, if you want it in a ball shape, when you dig down and get this and press it over against the side, this is pretty much that shape. You may want to work a little more with your hands. Now, that's a problem with these colors because those will come off on your hands. I'll show you on the red. But you may leave this as a ball, or you may flatten it. So I'm going to move over to the red and show you what we would do with this one if we decide to flatten it. And I'm going to try not to use my hands too much, but obviously to get it in a ball, you have to touch it lightly, and it's not terrible, but it will come out like that. So if you like this look better, then you can use a fork and just put that imprint on the top. So I'm going to continue to work on this, and as I finish each one of these, I'm going to place the ball over here where I have prepared a pan where I put a silicone pad, and that makes it really easy to deal with. You don't have to have that. If you have a baking pan like this, it's very shallow, that will work. Or if you have a cookie sheet That's fine. And just leave it ungreased. It doesn't have to have any grease. So I'll continue and be back to show you the finished candy. For the size of scoop we were using, the cream cheese candy mixture made 32 balls. And we have them in bright red, in white, and then bright green. So it looks very Christmassy. You need to let these sit for about 1 hour to harden. And then you can move them to your serving dish and you can serve immediately. My candy has set up and I'm going to transfer it from the pan to a nice candy dish. And I think it will look prettiest to mix them together. I'm going to take a taste of the cream cheese candy for you. And I'm going to pick white. I don't want this all over my teeth. And honestly, Rick and I probably will eat very few of these. We'll probably give them to our daughter and son-in-law or grandson because they like candy. Well, not my daughter so much, but we're trying to avoid calories and it's right into the Christmas season and it's hard to do that. So I wanted to cut it in two just to let you see the texture inside. That's the composition of the cream cheese candy. And then I'll take a little bite here. It's soft. It has that minty flavor since I use peppermint. You don't have to use that, but it kind of gives it more of a Christmas feel. Tastes really good. You know, it's really sugary, and probably people will comment, that candy is really sugary. Well, you saw the sugar go in, that's where it came from. But that's candy for you. So I hope you like it. I want to show you a gift that I received recently. And this is a gift from Bargab and Barnally Datta from Bangalore, India. And Bargab and Barnally are the ones who have worked on my website, which is bettyskitchen.us, if you've never visited it. And also he made the banner for Betty's Kitchen that is currently being used. And he also has done various things in terms of upkeep of the channel and also made the intro for each of the videos that you see nowadays. So he's been very special in my life. And he regards me as a special friend too, enough to send me a birthday gift. Thank you, Bargab and Barnally. I want to show what I got wrapped in this beautiful paper from India. First, we have two cards. You can see these are birthday cards. They're signed inside by Bargab and his wife, Barnally. They're beautiful. Thank you so much for those. And then they have sent me a handbag, which is just my style, really the kind of size that I would use and has compartments that I always need. I just love it. And then something that's really special to me is this picture frame. Now, the picture frame is heart-shaped, so that has a special feeling between our family and their family. And he has gone on the internet to some of the slideshows that I've done or maybe other places, and he has found a picture of me here. And here's Rick. And there's Remy right there. We've moved these around a little bit, Bargab. And there's Chelsea. And here's Chris. And then here's their son, Carter, who you may know from some of the videos already. But I think it's such a thoughtful gift, and I really appreciate it. And I wanted to tell you that Bargab and Barnally. Barnally has been working on her channel, and I'll be able to let you know more about it later on. But right now I don't have much information. With regard to Bargab, if you go to my website, which you'll see at the beginning of each description of a video that I have, you could go to that website and you will see that he is the designer of the website. Also, I'm going to put up here his channel name. So if you want to click and visit his channel, you can leave him a message if you want to. But thanks again for the lovely birthday gifts, Bargab and Barnally.